Welcome back to Exploring Montessori Math. My name is Kelly Nguyen. I'm the Director of Admissions at Butler Montessori. I'm also a trained elementary guide in AMI Montessori and did teach at Butler Montessori for a little bit and just transitioned to the admissions team over the summer. Hi, I see that we have some viewers. If you can comment, then I can see who you are, or you can do some of the emojis like the like or the heart. And they'll let me know that you are watching and who you are. Today we're going to be exploring the commutative law of multiplication. I wonder if you all remember that back from elementary school or maybe even middle school. This is going to help us prepare for some more squaring when we do them later. Hi Mickey, thanks for popping on. And anyone else who's watching, if you comment, then I can see who you are. I also have this video pulled up on the laptop so I can see any comments. So if you have any questions or comments, you can type them in and then I'll answer them as we go. I'll give us a couple more minutes and then I'll get started with the commutative law of multiplication. All right, I'll go ahead and get started. I'm gonna move my screen down so you can see what I'm working with. Hi Emma, hi Natasha, thanks for hopping on. All right, as you can see, I've been working on my mirrored writing. So here today, we're gonna be working with the commutative law of multiplication. Emma, I wonder if you remember having this lesson with me. Today, I'm going to show you something new. We've been working with multiplication, and now I'm going to show you something else with multiplication. Let's do 3 times 5. 3 times 5. That means I need to take 3 5 times. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. 3 taken 1 time. 3 taken 2 times. 3 taken 3 times, 3 taken 4 times, and 3 taken 5 times. Now, what is the answer going to be? Well, we can count it all up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. The answer is 15. I'm going to take my 10. I like this 10 better. And my 5 for 15. Now what if I want to do 5 times 3? I'm gonna take my 5 and my times and my 3. Now before I start this question, I'm gonna write down my previous problem and the answer. Alright, now let's take 5 3 times. 5 taken 1 times, 5 taken 2 times, and 5 taken 3 times. I'm going to count it up to see how much this is. Well, I know my 5 times table, so I can skip count. 5, 10, 15. The answer is 15. Again. I'm going to write that down. 5 times 3 is 15. Look at our answers. We have 15 and 15. They're the same. Let's do another one. That makes me curious about something. I'm going to clean this one up and let's do another problem. The next problem I'm going to do is 2 taken 7 times. If you know the answer, maybe you can type it in the comments below. I'm going to do a pretty design and then write my problem. I need to take 2 7 times. 1 time, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, count that all up. Ooh, I know my twos. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. My answer is 14. I need a 10 and a 4. This time, I'm going to do 7 times 2. I'm going to take 7 2 times. You're right, Emma, Natasha. All right, I'm gonna write down my problem. Here's my first problem. Now I'm working on my second problem. I need to take 7 2 times. Here's 7 1 time and 7 2 times. You know, I haven't finished learning all of my sevens times table, so I'm gonna go ahead and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Oh my goodness, the answer is 14 again. I'm gonna write that down and look at this. 14 and 14. 7 taken 2 times is 14, and 2 taken 7 times is 14. The answer is the same. I wonder if this would happen with another set. And I could keep going on and showing them examples of the different facts. And eventually we'll get to the realization that it doesn't matter which order we put the numbers in. So for my last example, I could say 4 taken 6 times is 24, and 6 taken 4 times is 24. It doesn't matter which order we put the numbers in when we're multiplying, the answer will be the same. This is a law in multiplication called the commutative law of multiplication. Thank you for watching, and then I'm going to show you something else that's fun for the children to do as a follow-up work. So of course they can just follow up the way I just did it, or another fun way is they can draw a picture. So they can do 2 taken 3 times, and they can draw the 2 bead bar. So the 2 bead bar is green. And then they can put out the 2 3 times. So here's 2 1 times, 2 times, and 3 times. And then draw a 6 bead bar, which would be purple. And that's one way for them to practice their facts. All right. Well, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Next week, I'm going to do the distributive law of multiplication. And this was a prereq to the distributive law, which is a little bit longer. Thank you for the heart. And then that's going to introduce some actual squaring for us for the following weeks after that. I'm really excited to get into the more difficult math that we're going to do. So I have to show you some foundation before we can get into the true squaring, and really, really excited about that. All right, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.